Hello everyone, my name is Steven Wolfe. Welcome to Let's Play Detective Grimoire. This is actually a bit of a... I've wanted to play this game for a while now. I saw it on the Steam page. I got stupid lucky, a friend of mine got it for me. But... You'll have to forgive how fucked up I sound right now. I'm in the middle, possibly the last half of a head cold. So, hopefully I'll be sounding better as this series progresses. But I have very fond memories of playing the original Detective Grimoire on Armor Games. If I remember correctly, that was a murder mystery at a circus. And I don't have the software to record off of Armor Games' website. Otherwise, I would play through that first so you guys would know what you're getting into. But Detective Grimoire is exactly what it says on the tin. It is a detective game. We are a detective. It's going to be a puzzle game. I know those go over so well with the internet. But because of the nature of this game and because of the cartoony graphics, I'm actually going to try and curb how much I normally swear. So, you know, you guys can throw stuff at me every time I swear. So, let's get the adventure started. Start with save file 1. Oh boy, whoa, one second. Yes, tap to create new save file? Is this like a phone game or something? Headphones strongly recommended. Sound is important. You'll need sound to properly experience this game. Okay, cool. Armor Games. I'll just move the mouse out of the way. We have voice actors this time. Cool.
2025, last night, a murder occurred in a remote part of this swamp. A small tourist attraction deep within the heart of the Martian.
Hold on. A tourist attraction?
I know that voice.
Here? I don't get it. Why would anyone...
And he has a hat, finally!
I've explained this already. This area is famous.
Famous. All I read was that some...
Oops. Damn it! All I read was that some idiot thought they saw an alien here 100 years ago.
Get your facts straight for once.
Sorry, I won't skip any of the dialogue.
About
this
is beautiful.
A creature
that's lived in the swamp for over 60 years.
Okay, so it's a 60-year-old alien. I still don't see why it matters.
If it matters to anyone, it's you. That creature is our prime suspect.
The murder suspect?
That's right. This is no Loch Ness Monster. You need to be taking this seriously.
No, look, come on. How am I supposed to arrest something that might not exist?
You've always enjoyed a challenge before. You can start by reading this.
Our case file? There's not a lot of it, is there?
As usual, we only know the bare essentials at this point.
Okay. Sorry, right now I'm just fangirling over the voice actor that's playing Grimoire. Anyone who has been on, who was on Armor Games or Newgrounds in the 90s, anyone who is a Flash gamer who is worth their salt, better know that frickin' voice. The Trapped series, Sunny, those are the ones off the top of my head. I think he did some voice acting in Sunny, I can't remember, but I know that voice. That dude is Flash Game God, as far as I'm concerned. Okay, let's look at this police file. Richard Remington, founder of tourist attraction Boggy's Bog, was found dead outside his office at 2:45 last night. Exact cause of death is unknown. Three small wounds to the chest suggest an attack from a clawed creature. Slime around the wound and footprints at the scene suggest the culprit was Boggy, the legendary swamp creature. Any of the 7 other people present in the swamp last night could hold vital information. Those are the wound marks and claw. Those are odd wound marks. Really, bitch. It looks like stab wounds, and then someone used slime to cover their tracks. I don't trust that for
a
second.
Victim, Richard Remington.
Sorry, one second. I need to blow my nose.
Of this tourist attraction. Boggy's Bog? What a name.
Boggy is the name of our creature. Well, nowadays it is.
You mean that stupid cartoon character? I've heard of him. That thing is our murder suspect?
There's more to Buggy than the cartoon character, I promise you. This is the place it all began. You'll find out soon enough.
So yes, every fan of the original Grimoire is just losing their stuff because he never... Ah, oh, he did lose the hat. Finally. He never had the hat in the original
your
game.
Your case file is in the top right.
Okay.
You can look at your clues and suspect profiles in here.
Okay.
When you've collected some, of course.
Yeah.
I'll stay and guard our boat. So if you're confused, come back here and I'll help you.
Okay, so yeah, in the original game, Grimoire didn't have his hat... So that's the police file. Grimoire didn't have his hat. So, you know, people, the entire original game gave him a ration of shit for it.
That's where I need to go. I can switch to walk mode with the button in the bottom right. Oh, and if I can turn off those sparkly hit icons in the options menu.
Sparkly hint icons? Yeah, you know what? Hardcore, why not?
A simple wooden dock. Looks like it can just about hold my weight.
Well, it's a good thing you lost weight, eh?
That's the biggest tree I've ever seen.
All right, let's go. Hi there.
Wow, you didn't get lost yet.
No, I only just got here. Who are you?
You don't remember.
You're the kid from the other place.
Of course, you're not great at remembering. I should be offended, though.
You're that weird girl from the fairground.
You're that weird girl from the fairground.
Saw your hat.
She was in the original game.
You must be slow. If it wouldn't even wait for you.
Well, if you'll let me, I'd better go after it. You can wait here and behave.
You'll get lost. I would never forgive myself if I let you go through without the map.
You have a map of the swamp?
Not anymore. I'm giving it to you.
You should really stay here. It's dangerous. There's been a murder. Although, I suppose you know all about it already?
They're saying it was the creature. But it can't be him. He doesn't seem like a killing sort of creature. Nope. He's a different sort of creature.
Wait, what do you mean? If you... she disappeared.
Just like the original game. I love it.
Is an opportunity for a photographic memento. The two characters are an explorer and Boggy himself. Are they fighting?
Yeah, the picture looks like the explorer's got Boggy in a headlock, and Boggy's not having any of it.
Just an odd old tree. It's an old statue of Boggy. His feet are hidden in a bucket of murky water. It's an old statue.
Okay.
The fence that seems to surround this entire area. I still don't quite understand why we have a tourist attraction here. Don't forget to use walk mode to move around.
I didn't forget. I have a map, though? Okay, so there's a bunch of other situations. It's west side of the swamp, so it's somewhere around here. It's any of these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 locations.
I don't forget.
Right, walk mode.
Just my luck. Looks like I can move these metal latches around. I should just have to slide at least one of them out of the... Then I'll be able to... Probably.
Oh god, our first puzzle. Okay, so let's see. I'm gonna go for brownie points. Nope, that needs to go up. There. That. Go there. That will need to go...
Hey, nice. How am I?
Cool.
This is the tourist attraction? The whole thing just doesn't make sense to me. Let's do some thinking. Drag any two stray thoughts into those slots at the bottom and flick through the connecting statements in between to make a sentence. Tap the confirm button to try it out. I just have to focus my thoughts and reach a conclusion. Boggy's bog seems like the middle of nowhere.
Okay, so the original game had this as well. It was a weird, it was a unique system to put the clues together. I've noticed certain puzzle games have this nowadays. Specifically, if I can think of a really good puzzle series that I need to do some videos for. Oh god, what was it called? The Blackwell series. If I remember correctly, it only had 5 games. The creators didn't want to drag it out. But the Blackwell series had a similar thing where you would connect the two thoughts and see whether what sort of stuff would pop out from there. So, yeah. The swamp is far too remote for this place to have happened.
The swamp is far too remote for the tourist attraction to have happened.
Ooh, that's...
to make any money. There we go.
The swamp is far too remote for the tourist attraction to make any money.
It's real. What's the story behind it?
Can I do any more of those? Clues. Suspects. Notes.
Not suspicious. Suspicious? Not suspicious.
No, it's suspicious. It is very suspicious. Okay, so let's see.
It's a fork in the road. How non-linear.
Yeah, nice fourth wall break there.
Apparently, it is a museum to the left and a cafe to the right. I'm not hungry, though. This place is putting me off food. Note to self, don't fall in.
Eyes.
There's a hollow part of the tree, right at the front, but it's too dark to see inside.
Oh, here's the murder victim. Okay, so we only have 2 suspects right now. Mr. Remington, the murder victim, and Boggy. Okay, well... it said that it was to the west of the swamp, so... ooh, hello.
These flower petals seem a little out of place, lying on the ground over there. A rather prominent tree stump looming over the wooden pathway. It's hard to ignore. I should visit the crime scene before I do anything else. I think Officer James said it was to the west.
Yeah, I'm heading the right way. Okay. I don't like how he's shoehorning me into the this, but...
there's a narrow path here leading up that hill and through the tree. It doesn't look inviting. I'm not sure it's part of the tourist attraction.
Let's see what's up here. Oh, well, we found the crime scene. Hey. Okay, so we got shoe prints leading to the area, and boggy prints leading in, around, and then to the body.
There are bizarre footprints with 3 toes leading up to the office door and back down into those reeds by the water. It's Remington's office, but I don't think I have a choice. So, this is where they found Remington's body.
Hey, I got an achievement. Cool.
There's an open window above Remington's body. One of the curtains is ripped and hanging on the outside.
Can I go in?
I can't get in here without a key. And I don't feel like kicking the door down. Maybe if I get desperate later on.
Okay.
I don't like it here.
Ditto.
The strange footprints stop right by these reeds. Maybe I should take a... maybe I can move some...
ah, there's a flipper.
A strange pair of green flippers, badly hidden in the reeds outside the office.
Well. Well, we know it wasn't Boggy.
Not suspicious.
Okay, so someone is obviously trying to use the legend of Boggy. Why are there sticks in the road?
There are...
Okay, it's just the footprints.
I don't... It's Remington's office.
Okay. Okay, hello.
Ah, some suspects. Let's get this investigation started.
Hi, person.
Oh?
All right, let's see. Another suspect for my notebook.
That's a little rude.
No, I'm sorry. Did I say that bit out loud?
Maybe not. Maybe I can hear your thoughts.
So would you be able to answer my questions before I asked you?
Would you be able to question my answers before I tell you?
I could try.
Oh, good God.
I'm Bobby Burl, professional cameraman. Pleased to meet you.
I'm Detective Grimoire. I'm here to investigate last night's murder. Obviously.
Grimoire. Strange. Is that your first name?
It's my second name.
It's my second name. Detective is my first name.
Okay, present a clue.
What is it? Some evidence from...
You were here yesterday, I presume? Last night?
Yes, I was.
Here, in this clearing?
No, I was over at the cafe getting something to eat. Richard Remington was there, too.
Remington? You saw him last night? Just before the murder?
That's right, I saw him. He left the cafe looking rather ill. I offered to help, but he just wanted to go back to his office. He looked like he had a lot on his mind.
He was ill yesterday?
Perhaps it was something he ate.
So what exactly are you doing here?
So you already told me what you do, but now, why would a cameraman be working here?
I go where I'm needed. Vincent wanted to come to the swamp, and I was happy to help.
Vincent Vanderpeer? You mean that man standing on that rock over there?
That's right. I've worked with him for many years.
Is he your boss?
Oh, I don't know about that. We work together. He's tried to film here before, but he never got permission until about a week ago.
Oh, really?
Huh.
But why did he want to come here in the first place?
If you're looking for a reason to write down in your notebook, I'm sure he can tell you if you ask him. I'm just the guy who carries around the camera.
You always carry that camera with you?
Most of the time.
What can you tell me about Boggy?
You should ask someone else.
What can you tell me about Remington?
Try showing it to somebody different.
What can you tell me about yourself?
A prolific cameraman with exceptional skills at carrying heavy equipment.
Okay. Well, thank you for your time, Mr. Burl.
What?
Oh, God.
Yes, do you have a message for me?
No, I don't think so.
Then why are you here? I'm incredibly busy.
You don't look it. Who are you, anyway?
What a question. You're serious? I am Vincent Vanderpeer.
The famous movie director?
The artist, the visionary, the auteur. I'm a man of many talents.
Clearly one of those talents isn't fixing your fucking hair. Damn it, I said I wouldn't swear. Sorry, guys. it's very obvious this guy has a big personality, so if I immediately start shooting him in the foot with his personality, it's going to be a problem. Let's hope you have a talent for answering my questions.
That's great. Let's hope you have a talent for answering my questions.
You're in my light. Could you take a few steps back, please?
But then I'll be too far away to talk to you.
I know.
Can anyone just walk in here and start filming? Bobby Burl only recently got permission from Richard Remington to film here in the swamp. Vincent Vanderpeer only recently got permission from Richard Remington to film here in the swamp. I wonder if Mr. Vanderpeer has been breaking rules. Or maybe he'll have an excuse.
Oh. He might not have actually gotten permission.
What?
What's a famous guy like you doing in a place like this?
Quite. I'm sure you're thinking, why doesn't he send an assistant? But that's not the way this director works.
But what are you doing?
I'm feeling, I'm experiencing, I'm discovering. This area, the history, the atmosphere, it's the perfect setting for my next film. I'm on a scouting mission to get to know this swamp before I begin work on the latest masterpiece in a string of masterpieces.
You're making a movie about Boggy? About the swamp creature?
Of course. He's a fascinating individual, isn't he? So mysterious.
No idea. I haven't met him yet. Is that your cameraman over there?
Yes, that's right. Bobby Burl, my faithful right-hand man. Well, faithful enough, you know.
No, I don't know.
He's an expert cameraman. Really knows his trade, of course. But he gets a bit muddled when it comes to priorities.
Like how? You mean he's lazy? He doesn't look lazy. He looks a bit scary.
Oh, no, nothing of the sort. He just has a little hobby that sometimes distracts him from his work. But I wouldn't want anyone else shooting for me.
So what exactly were you up to last night?
Were you working yesterday? Here in the swamp, I mean?
Indeed I was working. Very hard indeed. Well into the night.
Hard work, is it? Getting to know the swamp?
You jest. But yesterday I was getting even more involved than usual. Yes, difficult to comprehend, I know.
So what kind of work were you doing?
Well, I was, unable to find my faithful cameraman last night. He had hidden himself quite completely from view.
Bobby Burl, right? Did you need him to film for you?
Always. But being a resourceful type of man, I stepped up and took on the responsibility myself. I was filming in this exact area, in fact.
Sorry, one second. I had set the timer for 120 minutes, you know, 2 hours, but apparently this thing is retarded. So now I gotta actually set it for 90 minutes. Okay, so he was filming in this area. I apologize, guys. Damn it! Fuck it. You know what? Forget it.
You were filming? Last night? Here?
Yes, at the time of the murder, I believe. But wait, I know what you're thinking. Now, don't forget, I'm not here to shoot some experimental documentary. I have no interest in late-night surveillance footage.
Did you see anything at all? What is it you were filming?
The water. I was filming the water. It's a fascinating subject, one that has me captivated to the point where
you didn't see anything useful? Side there for a minute.
Nothing useful to you, my good detective. But there are some odd sounds on the audio track. Nothing but wild animals going about their nighttime rituals, I'm sure.
Is there something I should ask the cameraman?
Let's see. Oh, ask the cameraman.
Vincent van der Peer told me that Bobby Burl was nowhere to be found last night. Simple enough. What was Mr. Burl doing last night that meant he couldn't help out his boss?
Not to mention, what was van der Peer up to?
I don't know if it's any use to you at all. I'll film again tonight and try to get a version without all those bizarre...
What can you tell me about Boggy?
Ah, yes. The reason we're all here, of course.
Not me.
Isn't he your prime suspect?
Well, officially, yeah, but I mean...
What an amazing creature! No one has seen him for 60 years and he still manages to get accused of murder! Incredible!
What can you tell me about Remington?
Now there's a man who could handle himself.
I'm not so sure.
Well, apart from yesterday, that was just a one-off, wasn't it?
For him, I think so, yes.
Okay.
I heard this isn't the first time you've tried to film here.
Where? In the swamp? What are you talking about?
Remington denied you the filming permission in the past.
Remington has denied you the filming permission in the past.
Oh, that. Nothing but the natural process of being in a profession like mine. Every situation simply requires the right approach before the gears start turning smoothly. You understand, I'm sure.
Why did Remington not want you filming here? And why did he change his mind?
It wasn't even up to him. This area is protected, you know. There are certain rules, certain regulations. I encounter this kind of thing all the time, really.
That doesn't explain why he changes tune. It's a little suspicious.
Why would you say that?
A famous movie director suddenly gets his... I wonder how that happened. Time to use my notebook. Just drag an item onto the paper to draw the idea.
All legitness? Money.
Right. That's... I think you bribed Remington to get the filming rights.
Well, bribe is a strong word. It was just a little arrangement between friends. Nothing worth getting upset about. I simply promised him a cut of my next movie's profits. It made sense, since he owned the area anyway. Just a favor for a favor.
So you would have owed him money?
Only a small percentage, simply out of courtesy. And not for a long time, either.
See, me, I was thinking a bit more harsh. I was thinking that Vanderpeer had... You know, the words he used when he described, hey, I deal with this stuff all the time, it felt more along the lines of he spoke with a contractor or one of those city areas. We'll get to this. It felt like he had spoken to some... to a... what are they called? A city council member, and had the swamp, you know, double-check the paperwork on the swamp to see if it was... I don't know. Protected territory, and because of that, he was legally allowed to film there. But, yeah...
Vincent's work.
Oh, sorry.
What do you think all those noises are?
Well, judging by the time this was recorded, I'd be able to make a pretty good guess.
Pretty sure that those noises were the last couple seconds of Remington's life.
I heard from Mr. Vanderpeer over there that you were nowhere to be found last night.
Didn't I say I was at the cafe?
Yeah, you did. But your director needed you for some filming, and he couldn't find you. What were you doing that was so important?
Well, let's see. After I ate, I had a walk around the swamp. I didn't have my camera, so I was free to stretch my legs for once.
Where was your camera? Don't you carry it around with you all the time?
No, not all the time.
You left it with Vanderpeer and he used it.
You left it with Vanderpeer, and he used it instead that night.
That's right. He was looking after that camera. So I went for a late night stroll. This place is beautiful in the evenings.
You just walked around? You didn't do anything? Didn't see anyone?
Well, I can't say that. I have various ways to pass the time, you know.
Man, Vanderpierce said you had a side hobby.
Vanderpierce said you had a hobby on the side.
Is that what he said? Well, yes, he's right. I brought two cameras with me when I came here. I left my video camera, yes, but I have another one. It's much smaller, and it only takes black and white photographs. You know the kind I mean?
A really old one?
Yes, I suppose so. I've always enjoyed traditional photography, and this place is a wonderful opportunity to take some pictures of a natural environment.
So, you were having some time off to take black and white photographs? For fun?
Only one photograph. You have to be disciplined when you're not using a digital camera.
Can I see it?
Of course. I took it near the woods at the back of the swamp. It's quite an interesting shot, but the light qualities weren't perfect. Here we are. Feel free to take a look.
Wait, what? This? It?
Mm-hmm. I haven't developed it yet. Just brush the developing fluid over the photo to reveal the image.
What? Is that Boggy? The swamp creature just standing in the water?
It could be. Personally, okay. I'm not convinced, but I'll let you decide for yourself.
So, not even gonna lie, that suit looks like shit. That suit genuinely looks terrible. Notice the gloves are separate from the arms, and the long legs are stilts to get through the bog. So, let's look at Vanderpierce. He works with Bobby. It's not suspicious. Unable to find Burke. Suspicious. Filmed by himself last night. It's a little suspicious. Filming at the exact time of the murder. Highly suspicious. It's not suspicious that he made a string of popular fantasy movies.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Worked with Vanderpier for years. Not suspicious. Not carries suspicious. His camera most of the time. Not suspicious.
Not suspicious.
Not suspicious.
His hobby with photography isn't suspicious. Not even gonna lie.
Rocks sitting in the water. If that was a natural occurrence,
it's a highly convenient one. All right, let's explore a bit further. The Bog Museum. Hey, those are those flowers.
I don't think it's a window, but this hatch is shut at the moment. I can't see inside. This side of the museum is surrounded by blue and red flowers.
That was the kind that was in that further back area. Interesting.
That museum is quite... Which makes it look even more out of place in a swamp. Is it being held up in wooden supports? It's bizarre. The door's jammed unless I can get... Seems like I can work just until the gap in the... That top hat guy would have...
Sherlock Holmes, really?
This journal... It's full of drawings and notes all about Boggy. It seems to be the centerpiece of the entire museum.
Journal recorded 60 years ago by an explorer who first visited the swamp. The only record of Boggy existing contains notes and sketches of the appearance of the swamp creature. Boggy is shown with three small claws on each arm. The feet are always hidden in the water. There seems to be a page ripped from the back. So if his feet are always hidden, how do we know what kind of feet he actually has?
These are skulls? Oh, they're just models. Creepy models. Models of Boggy's claws. Hold on. What's this? Something doesn't seem right here. I think I should try arranging these models into pairs. Something seems out of place.
Oh.
I don't think these gloves are part. Looks like someone tried to hide them here.
They're flippers. Ugh.
It's a poster from the old Boggy cartoon show.
Wow, Swamp Studios. I'd take the time to figure out what the copyright is, but I don't think you guys wanted to take that time.
Some educational facts about swamps. Did you know swamps are gross?
Yes, we did.
Yes? Yes, I did.
So.
Hello, person.
Let me guess, you don't work here, do you? I wonder if that makes you the first tourist I've seen today.
You're incorrect, detective.
Oh, I already don't like this guy.
I am no mere tourist.
How did you know I was a detective? Was it my stylish trench coat, my sensitive, inquisitive manner?
It was the clueless expression on your face.
What are you talking
about? Jerk.
Yeah, that's the one.
Right. That's it. You've done it now. What's your name?
I go by Folder. Agent Folder. What are you doing?
Agent Folder? I'm writing bad things about you.
I'm writing bad things about you in my notebook. So, if you're not a tourist, and you don't work here...
I am a scholar, an academic. I'm here to research the past and uncover the future.
So, you're visiting the museum for fun.
Fun! Oh, there's nothing so simple as fun to be had here. I come to this museum night and day to study its secrets.
Ah, what kind of secrets? It's just a museum about Boggy, right? The swamp creature.
He's one of the most intriguing modern examples of cryptozoology. A fascinating combination of scientific fact and wild speculation.
I'm with you on the speculation front. Although, come to think of it, people have been hinting that I should find out about the history of this creature.
A wise suggestion. And you've come to the right person. My knowledge far exceeds anyone else you might have met so far.
So, I like how he's just got a drawer in his pocket.
I suppose I could divulge some of my findings with you. If you're in the mood for a little light reading, let me find it for you. Oh, yeah, this'll do. Something for beginners, at least.
Bruh. Boggies. Boggy Swamp became a protected area for... There. Boggy Swamp became a protected area after reports of hunting in the area. Boggy's appearance has changed from the original sketches, in which he has three claws on each arm. The modern character has fin-like arms instead, to make him less threatening. No footprints have ever been recorded in the journal, but some experts believe the information is out there somewhere. Hmm. Interesting. Where were you last night?
Mr. Folder.
Agent Folder.
Yeah. Were you here yesterday? What were you doing last night?
I was here, in the museum, going through my files one final time before disappearing into the night.
Don't museums usually close in the evenings?
They do. I've never been one to worry about other people's schedules. I come and go as I please.
So you broke in?
There's a key to every lock, detective.
Oh, so you have the key to the museum?
Of course I don't. Why would you think that?
Well, I...
Once again, that clueless expression. I use a lockpick and get in through the small side door. I have a right to be here, you see. Remington has no business locking me out, so I don't let him.
You just admitted to breaking the law. If everyone did that, my job would be a lot easier.
No kidding.
It's not my best lockpick. This new one's cheap. I used to own one, a superior model. Unfortunately, I misplaced it in one of the darker corners of the swamp, so I don't...
I'm writing down your confession about sneaking around here at night.
Then what are you gonna do? Report me to Remington? Good luck, my friend.
Can you tell me about the gloves?
The real swamp creature had claws. Three on each hand, to be precise. Why does the costume just have these pathetic fins instead?
Hey. The photo that he took.
Actually, this is a classic example of a cryptid photograph.
What's a cryptid?
A creature unknown to science. Look at the slight blurring in this photo, the murky exposure. It's perfect.
It's perfect because it can't really be used as evidence?
Now you're catching on.
One sec. The photo. Feet can't be seen. Flippers. That's someone in a costume. He was helping Vanderpeer. Okay, I'm on to you, boogers.
I've never seen that before? And I never want to see it again.
Okay.
Guesswork. Nobody can know what Boggy's feet look like. It's his greatest secret.
That's what I thought. What can you tell me about Remington?
The man was a fool. That's all you need to know.
Alright, well, what can you tell me about yourself?
This person is of no interest to me whatsoever.
This is why you always have a line to describe what someone else said, what they say about themselves. What can you tell me about Boggy?
Are you asking about the cartoon character? Because I have no interest in such childish matters.
No, I think I'm asking about the actual creature. What's the difference anyway?
Everything!
What can you tell me about Bobby Burl?
If I cared about that person, I would know everything I need to know already.
How about Vanderpeer?
Next time, only show me something if it's important. Let's make that a rule.
You're a dick. Okay, that's all the people. What do you think of the Explorer's Journal?
An important piece of the puzzle. This journal is a key to unlocking the history of this place.
All right, well, he's not useful for now. I haven't unlocked other information.
There's a little door in the wall here. I think it leads outside. It's locked, though.
All right. Well, that was a museum. That was interesting. Where am I? Oh, that's the office. Okay. So, yeah, let's keep going around.
What's this? Looks like the stuff in the water has been moved around recently. Maybe.
Oh, whoa. Hello, Clue.
Staircase is a tree, and this tree is a staircase, and this place is so weird.
yes, it is.
The water's clear here. I can see my reflection. Not bad. What's this?
So something was standing there.
The water's clear here. I can see my reflection. Not bad.
Let me jump and double check that picture. Okay. So the person who... So Bobby took the picture here.
This staircase at
Bobby took the picture here. Who's standing where we're standing? Took the picture of someone in a boggy suit. Let's see what the clues about folder is. A lot of time in the museum. Not suspicious.
Not suspicious.
Deep interest in cryptozoology. Not suspicious.
Not suspicious.
Knows a lot about the quote real creature. It's not suspicious.
Not suspicious.
Lockpick suspicious. Bought a new one after losing the old one. Also suspicious. Who else?
Uh-huh.
Bobby. We already went through him. Yeah, so let's continue onward. Ooh, cutscene. Oh, cool.
I wouldn't be using this old rope bridge if I had a choice.
Ditto.
I've seen the movies, I know what happens.
I don't know, at this point it kind of reminds me of one of the worlds from Myst, so it's kind of cool.
Someone please tell me why there's a house here. Well, the lights are on. Maybe somebody's home. It feels like I've stepped into nighttime. What happened to the sun?
It's somewhere out there.
I've seen...
Right.
The latch is broken. It seems I can fix it with those three cogs if I just put them in the right place. Once they're on the right pins, I can move the handle at the bottom. Try and open the door.
Yay, puzzle. Okay, so... Nope. What if I put that there?
Perfect.
Hey! There we go.
I am amazing.
Hello, Leaf Hat. I will talk to you in a minute.
There's a whole load of needles and wool on that shelf. Or should I say yarn?
That's yarn.
I just don't know anymore.
No, that's... If those are that big, that's crochet needles, and that's yarn, definitely. I would know this stuff. My mom crochets.
The owner of this house seems to enjoy reading. Though, I'm not sure what else there is to do up here, actually. A little blanket on a little bed in a little house. It makes very little sense.
True.
I'm indoors.
What a treat.
This is like an oven? Or is it just a boiler?
It's an oven.
It's so old-fashioned, it hurts my brain. Check out that sunlight beaming through the window. It's so bright, I should have brought my sunglasses. The tree comes straight through the middle of the house. It even has little drawers carved into it.
Wouldn't you?
Okay, even I'll admit, that's pretty cool.
Exactly. Hello, person.
Mm-hmm.
Hi.
You just walked straight into my house, did you?
Sorry, I would have rung the bell.
Sorry, I would have rung the bell, but you don't have one.
Normally, I have methods for dealing with unwanted attention. But I can make exceptions for harmless idiots.
Do you get any attention up here?
Most of the time, people like to leave me alone. But I don't think you're going to, are you?
No. I could make an excuse and say it's my job to ask you about last night, but to be honest, I climbed all the way up here and I just like being indoors.
Well, if you insist on staying, I'll tell you. I'm Lady Weybridge, and I think you might be climbing up the wrong trees.
I'm Detective Grimoire, and I think I might agree with you.
Mm-hmm. All right, so what do you do?
What do you do here? Did you work for Richard Remington?
I was living here before that man was even born. And I have absolutely nothing to do with him, or his little tourist attraction.
You're exaggerating. How long have you been here? Just in this treehouse? What do you do up here?
I've been here longer than anyone. Even longer than... well, anyone.
I like numbers.
60 years, something like that.
What have you been doing for that time? If you don't mind me asking.
I have many reasons to be here, but I won't bore you with all the details of my life.
I'm sure there's one detail worth writing down.
I like to study the plants and flowers in this area. I've learned many things from them.
Now, what about this little chemistry set you've got on your table?
I wouldn't call it a chemistry set. But if you bring me an object that has liquid on it, or inside it, I'll tell you what that liquid consists of.
Wow. How do you do that?
Chemistry.
Okay, just a second. I need to double check something. Okay, yeah, so I've been recording a little under an hour. That's good. Let's keep going, shall we? Page from Weybridge's Book of Pressed Flowers contains information all about the flowers in the swamp where they grow. Green and red species only grow around the side door of the museum, can't be found anywhere else. That flower was found on the docks earlier. I found a flower on the docks earlier. Interesting. What were you up to last night?
Your job is to ask me about what happened last night.
Yes, it is.
Do you even know what happened last night?
I know more than you might imagine.
Oh, that sounds useful. Can you tell me? What were you doing?
I was here, in my house, by myself.
Frickin'.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
What else?
That's it.
Thanks.
Bitch!
Just give me a minute to write all this down.
You're about as useful as a bag of hammers. All right, present a clue. The gloves have liquids.
Let's see. First thing we do is put the sample of liquid into the cauldron, then tap the faucet.
Splash.
Now, we just have to match the color of that liquid with these ingredients.
You're gonna make me do a color palette test, bruh.
Okay.
What mixes with red and... what mixes with what and what to make green? Crap. I want to say blue and yellow. Yes! Haha!
Now I know what that liquid consists of. I'll write it down in my notes.
Sludge, clearly. Okay, tell me about these flippers.
If you bring me something with liquid on it...
Okay. What can you tell me about Bobby Burl?
I'm not even sure who that is.
Okay. What can you tell me about Vanderpeer?
You should ask someone else.
What can you tell me about yourself?
A fascinating old woman who lives in a wonderful treehouse. I heard she wasn't so keen on visitors, though.
Sassy, I like it. Okay, wait, have you ever heard of someone by the name of Agent Folder?
Show it to someone who doesn't live in a tree.
Good point. What can you tell me about Mr. Remington?
I have nothing good to say about that man.
Well,
so I won't say anything at all.
Yeah, super useful. Can you tell me about Boggy?
I'm not even sure who that is.
You
can put that away. I can't help you with it.
Alright, fine. We're not gonna get much of anything useful from her.
I'm in door.
She'll be useful later on, I'm sure. But right now, ew.
Predictably, a trash can. And I just can't resist taking a look inside. The glamorous life of a detective. My favorite part of the job.
Oh, hello.
Hello, what's this? Just a piece of paper or something more sinister?
Looks like designs for a Boggy costume. I found the gloves, I found the flippers. Now I need the pants, the body, and the head.
Are we really talking about a swamp creature here? Design I found in the trash can explains what Burl's black and white photo is showing me. My detective's intuition is kicking in. That black and white photograph, I'm not sure I'm looking at the real Boggy here. And I think these designs I found in the trash can might be the answer.
I'm about 15-20 minutes ahead of you, Grimoire. Sorry, bro.
Oh, and I should start looking for the costume itself. If I can find that, there'll be some pretty impressive evidence.
Oh, we're on chapter 2. Okay.
I have something for you.
Another gift already. Where are you keeping all this stuff? You don't even have pockets in that dress.
I don't need a pocket to carry a key.
What key?
I don't know. You could try it on any door you like. Although, I recommend you try it on the office door.
Remington's office?
Sassy little booger. All right.
Water, water everywhere.
Not a drop to drink.
Seriously, I'm not drinking that.
I wouldn't suggest it.
There's a little locked door on the side of the ship here. I think it's part of the cafe. A shipwreck? In a swamp? Does that make any sense?
Not really. It doesn't
and
have
why
to.
Is there a cafe growing out of the side?
Well, let's talk to... oh, there's a menu.
A shipwreck? There's a wooden path built right into the ship. The rope bridge leads up through those trees. Do they expect tourists to climb up there? It looks dangerous.
Hello, person.
Ah, yes. I heard they were sending somebody over. So you're Detective Grimoire.
At your service. Well, kind of. You're a suspect, too.
Subtle.
Of course, of course. Feel free to be as suspicious as you like. I won't be offended. You can call me Harper.
How did you know my name?
I can only assume I must have read about one of your many exploits. But I think you'll find the swamp to be your greatest challenge.
I love challenge. I eat challenge for breakfast.
The swamp itself has a history that has captured many imaginations, for better or for worse. My advice to you, look to the past. It could be the way forward.
Okay. I got a clue. What can you tell me about... Oh, I don't know. You know what? What do you do here?
So, you sit in this boat all day and sell food to people? To tourists, I guess?
Not just the tourists, but the employees, too. To anyone who is hungry or thirsty. I know everyone's favorite foods.
What are they? Oh, and is this a real shipwreck? How did it get here?
I can't expose all the secrets of the swamp. I don't want to spoil your fun.
Is there a secret to this shipwreck?
No.
You just spoiled my fun.
You'll find out there are some secrets worth keeping when you've worked here as long as I have.
Well, how long is that?
I've worked in the swamp almost as long as Mr. Remington. We knew each other for a long time.
Really? So what was his favorite food?
Mr. Remington enjoyed a specialty only I can make, the bog dog. He ate one nearly every day. A real creature of habit, that one.
It looks like a hot dog.
It's similar, but I'm afraid I have to disappoint you. I'm not serving them today.
Why not?
Yesterday I found this strange green powder in my entire supply.
Guess I'm out of luck today. Well, thanks for the information. You've been a real big help.
Wait, take this with you. If you get thirsty, it's the most popular drink in Boggy's Bog. Swamp juice. Try it.
It looks like... It looks... Well, I'll try some later on.
You're in luck. That's my last bottle. A lot of swamp juice has been disappearing from my stock recently. I can only assume I must have been selling them all.
Did something strange happen at the cafe yesterday? Richard Remington left the cafe feeling ill after Hopper sold him a bog dog. Hopper is basically in charge of all the food and drink here in Boggy's Bog. I'll have to ask him about this.
Definitely. But...
You're going to ask me about what I was doing last night.
I was going to. Were you going to tell me anything?
I was working here at the cafe in the evening. I had a couple customers. Eventually, they all left and I looked up and went home.
Do you lock away everything at night?
Not everything. Just the storeroom over there.
You mean that little door on the side of the ship? Is there anything else to lock?
I leave the chairs, tables, and trash can where they are. Lifting things like that is not a job for an old man.
Don't you have anyone to help you?
Mr. Remington liked to keep us down to his skeleton staff. There simply aren't many people who would choose to work in a place like this.
A skeleton staff? Well, that's convenient for him, since...
Don't make that joke. I won't laugh.
I don't know what joke he was trying to make there. What can you tell me about Remington?
He was a friend for many years. If you have any questions about him or his belongings, I may be able to help you.
Well, what can you tell me about yourself?
I don't know very much about them.
Thank you, game. What can you tell me about Lady Weybridge?
You have a lot of suspects on that list.
I have no idea. Bobby Burrow?
I don't know what to say.
Vanderpier.
I don't know very much about them.
Agent Folder.
You have a lot of suspects.
Boggy.
You're prime suspect, am I correct?
Well, technically. But I'm not even sure he's real.
Don't worry about that. Real or not, the creature's the most important part of this mystery.
Which one? The cartoon character or the real creature?
Exactly.
Yeesh. Well, what can you tell me about this bog dog?
It was Mr. Remington's favorite food. That strange green powder isn't supposed to be there.
So he was definitely poisoned. Okay. Flower book.
Why don't you show that to someone else?
Swamp juice?
It's the most popular drink that I sell. In fact, a lot of it has disappeared from my stocks recently.
Yeah, I know. You mentioned that before. Boggy costume.
Someone made a costume to look like the creature.
Yep.
They must have known it would get reaction for sure. I wonder if they planned things to go this far.
When you're finished theorizing, I was going to show you these sketches I found in the trash can right next to your cafe.
It does seem like someone was designing a costume. A disguise, perhaps.
I don't know.
Try to think why somebody would do such a thing.
I don't know.
What could they achieve with it?
I don't know.
Not yet.
I was told Remington left the cafe looking ill last night. Since you seem to be completely in charge of all the food and drink around here, I'm afraid this is something I can't ignore.
He was an old man. His health wasn't perfect. But I'm not arguing with you. I think it is suspicious. What do you think caused it?
What do I think caused it?
Personally, I think he was poisoned.
A bog dog he ate at the cafe gave him food poisoning.
I keep all my food locked in the storeroom when I'm not here. You think he was poisoned?
I think he was poisoned.
Poisoned by me?
Not on purpose.
The storeroom was broken into with a lockpick.
A lockpick? I've never encountered a problem like this before. But since last night, am I in a position to doubt a claim like that?
Somebody knew that Remington would eat a bog dog. He ate one every day, right?
Do you suppose this explains the missing bottles of swamp juice as well?
Possibly. All I know for sure is this is some fishy stuff going on. I love the music.
You don't know everything, I'm afraid.
Yeah, it's okay.
There's a little lock. I think it's... It's a humble gift shop wagon.
It's a lot of boggy stuff.
What on earth?
There's the helmet. And a red cloth? The curtain!
It's some kind of rough... There's a strange piece of red fab. Two clues for the price of one, I guess.
That cloth... That's the cloth from the curtain in Remington's office.
There aren't many clues over here. Unless those trees are a clue. But I don't think so.
Alright, let's talk to the chick. Hello.
Sorry to interrupt. I can see that you're, hard at work.
You weren't here yesterday.
I only just arrived.
Oh, no. I only just arrived.
You're the detective, right?
I'm a detective.
So, that was your hat I saw blowing through here.
Oh!
You spotted it too.
If you're good at your job, you may have realized that it's kind of dead around here. So I generally notice magical floating detective hats. Oh, and don't worry, you'll look better without it.
How do you know?
Oh, I have a good imagination.
So what do you do here?
I didn't expect to see someone your age working in a place like this. But then again, I didn't expect there to be a place like this in a place like this.
I only started working here this year anyway. It's temporary. Just running the gift shop to earn a little extra money. Don't ask how I ended up here.
I'll save that question for a different day.
Agreed.
You don't seem at home here, exactly.
I hate it. This place is disgusting.
Come on, you don't think it's kind of beautiful?
You would say that. You only just got here. You'll get sick of it.
If I wasn't here, I'd be stuck in my office doing paperwork.
At least at your office, you don't have to bring spare clothes every day. It's impossible to leave this place without being covered in dirt.
Challenge accepted.
Really, Grimoire?
When you have a moment free from your busy schedule, I need to ask you about last night.
I know, but it won't help. I worked here during the day, then left my gift shop and went home in the evening, same as every day.
You just leave your gift shop here when you go?
No, I put it in my pocket.
Yeah, seriously though, as much as I appreciate sarcasm, I think I'd get in trouble if I wrote something like that down in my notes.
Well, look, you've noticed the gift shop has wheels and you're thinking, oh, she's pretty lazy to leave it lying around. But if you want to try pushing this thing through the swamp, be my guest. And I can't lock it up, so I just leave it here overnight. Nobody's ever stolen any of this lousy merchandise anyway. I even left my spare clothes here when I went home last night.
You left them here? By the gift shop?
Yeah, it's no big deal. They were all still here this morning. Kind of.
Kind of?
I think someone played a stupid joke, and my spare black leggings were covered in some disgusting swamp slime when I found them in the bag this morning. If you're going to take my clothes and mess them up, then just keep them. I don't want them back. You know what I mean?
I absolutely do.
Son of a bitch. Head, gloves, flippers, leggings, torso. Okay. Someone had a plan. Hey, cuteness.
I have a theory that the murderer was wearing a costume. A homemade outfit designed to look like the swamp creature.
I've never seen anything so ridiculous. You've never seen me in that.
I know it's not exactly the latest fashion, but...
No, you'd never see me in that. It would cover me up entirely.
That's the point of a disguise?
Look, detective. When you have legs like mine, you don't want to be wearing disguises.
Is that why you always wear those black leggings?
You've only just met me, and you're making assumptions about what I always wear.
And making assumptions is the fun part of being a detective.
He's not wrong.
You're right. I always wear these.
She might be in on it. What can you tell me about Remington?
He made sure I always got paid, so I can't say anything bad about him.
You can if you like. He won't hear you.
You should have more respect for the dead.
No chill there. No chill, Grimoire. Seriously. All right, Vanderpeer.
I really don't know what to tell you.
Bobby Burl?
Is that one of the other suspects? They're more suspicious than me. Let's agree on that.
Everyone's a suspect. There is no innocence, merely degrees of guilt. What about Chef Harper?
Is that your new friend? Sweet.
Sassy little turd. What can you tell me about swamp juice?
I have no idea what that is.
Your leggings.
They're mine, but I left them here last night. Now they're covered in slime, and I don't want to go near them. Where are you keeping all this stuff? In your pockets?
Yes, he's got a coat of holding. Where are we now? Oh, okay, we went back around. So, let's go... Yeah, let's go to the office.
There's an open window above. One of the curtains is ripped and hanging on the outside.
That's bubbling.
What's this?
Oh!
There's a lockpick dropped amongst the... I just have to work out which vine to break and... That's the one, but I wonder where this lockpick came from.
Folder says this was his lockpick, but he lost it a while ago and had to buy a new one. Definitely used by the murderer. Huh. Let's go over our profiles for the people real quick. Well, they began working a year ago. It's not suspicious.
Not suspicious.
Face is disgusting. Not suspicious.
Not suspicious.
Long legs, always wears black leggings. Yeah, those are kind of suspicious. Often has to bring spare clothes. Didn't lock her belonging. Unable to lock the gift shop.
Not suspicious.
Harper. Knows everyone's favorite spoon.
Not suspicious. Not suspicious.
That's suspicious that the drinks went missing. Serves Remington the bog dog. Locks up when he leaves. It's known Remington.
Not suspicious. Not suspicious.
Unable to find Brawl.
Oh?
Worked for Vanderpeer for years.
So,
Folder spends a lot of time in the museum, not suspicious. What do we know about Lady Waybridge? Waybridge, sorry.
Not suspicious. Not suspicious.
Hates Remington. That's suspicious.
Not suspicious. Not suspicious. Not suspicious.
Before I look at this area, I need to talk to these guys.
I found these designs for a costume, a boggy costume.
The legendary swamp creature.
Yeah, that's the one.
But these are just a child's drawings, are they not?
You think?
Perhaps. It's difficult to tell.
I need to pick my questions carefully.
Sorry, one sec. That's the hint. Okay, lockpick. I was given by a found inside. Found this lock. The lockpick I found near Remington's body.
The lockpick I found near Remington's body might belong to Agent Folder. As far as I know, Agent Folder is experienced with lockpicks. I wonder if he's hiding something.
Agreed. What can you tell me about Waybridge?
I really don't have an opinion. My apologies.
Harper?
You should ask someone else.
I'm covering all the bases.
Try showing it to somebody different.
Yeah, I know. What can you tell me about Swamp Juice?
I'm sorry, I have not seen that before.
Bleh.
What is it? Some evidence from last night's murder?
Yeah, you're not going to be helpful. Okay, let's talk to him.
What can you tell me about these designs for a boggy costume?
Nothing whatsoever.
You're sure you didn't see anything like this while you were filming yesterday? Wait, hold on a minute. What if
Don't you dare ask.
This costume isn't your doing, is it? Made for your movie, I mean?
My friend, there will be no costumed idiots within the viewfinder of my camera. I can assure you that.
What about your boggy movie? Isn't that going to be, like, a guy in a costume or a puppet or one of those weird robot things?
Technology has been kind to people like me. We no longer have any need for such tomfoolery. I can create a perfectly believable swamp creature within the confines of a computer. Much cheaper, too.
Yeah, building a creature in CG is significantly cheaper.
The world's premier director, the king of wit and whimsy. You met him. You're a lucky man.
Well, he's good at selling himself, that's for sure.
He's been working with me for a number of years. A real expert, of course. You want me to sign a photograph for you? I'm a busy man, and this doesn't look like it's worth my time. He's a talented man, that Burl. Sometimes I wonder if he'd be better off pursuing his photography full-time, you know?
Yes, indeed.
If you want an autograph, a plain sheet of paper will suffice, thank you.
Really, bruh? I couldn't give a tuppenny screw what you know.
I don't really have time to be looking at items from your collection.
Okay. Let's head back this way. Oh, hello, person.
These flower petals seem a little...
Ah, you've arrived at a bad time, my friend. For once, they don't actually want tourists walking around this place.
Yeah, I know, right?
I always arrive at a bad time. It's what I do. I'm a detective, not a tourist.
My apologies. It's just, you have the same wide-eyed expression as the kids that come here. Running around, spending their parents' money, you know.
Well, you know, it's not every day I visit a swamp full of such unique specimens.
Agreed.
It's no problem. You're just thinking what we all thought when we arrived for the first time.
Why didn't they put in a bathroom?
No, you're thinking, this place is beautiful. What a lucky man I am to be here.
I am I? Well, if you say so.
Edward Everstone, at your service.
That's a pretty cool name. Can I call you Ed?
You don't need to. Everyone just calls me Echo.
Gives you an elevated sense of purpose?
Why? Because it gives you an elevated sense of purpose?
I had to sass him on that.
No.
I apologize.
Because I always come back, again and again, until my job is done.
What is your job, exactly?
You're protesting, right?
I certainly am. And now that you're here, I'm getting you involved.
What does that mean? Yeah, I haven't got time to hold up signs for you. I'm sorry.
You simply have to hear my message and take it with you.
Go ahead. I'm all ears. Plus, I have a little notebook.
What was the first thing you felt when you saw the sign for Boggy's Bog looming over you?
Well, I thought it was...
Not thought. Felt.
I felt... Well, something seemed wrong. There wouldn't be a tourist attraction in the middle of a swamp like this. There shouldn't be.
My job is done. Clearly your brain is working perfectly, Detective.
So you're against the tourist attraction? Let's see, you'd rather this area was kept as a natural habitat, right?
Right again. And that precise word, habitat. First and foremost, I'm protesting for animal rights.
Well, okay, I'm following you, but it's not like they're cutting down trees or anything like that, right?
All animals deserve the right to live in peace, and I promise you, on a normal day, this place is far from peaceful.
Are you talking about the swamp creature? About Boggy?
A creature like that. He's earned the right to be left alone. We're fools to invite ourselves into his home like this on a daily basis, assuming he's not going to mind. Assuming he'll keep to himself and let us walk around with his face on our t-shirts.
Well, I agree. I think he should be left alone. But, like you said, he can probably handle himself. And if no one has even seen him in 60 years, I don't really see the problem.
Unlike you, Detective, I never had an academic calling in life. I was never even a talented artist or musician or anything. So instead, I made the decision to stand up for those who were getting a raw deal.
Okay, I think we're talking to the murderer. Look at this from my perspective. This guy has been arguing for animal rights at this bog probably for a very long time. I think he worked with Burke to prove that Boggy was a real creature, and then took it a step further because Remington found out and killed him. Possibly with a pitchfork, or stabbed him 3 times, and then used swamp water around the wound. He was still in costume, so if anyone saw it, they saw Boggy stab Remington.
Ooh. I'm afraid I have no idea.
You come here every day?
Yes, I do.
Well, I'm only going to ask you about one of those days. What were you doing yesterday evening?
I was here at my protest spot until fairly late. Then I went to get something to eat at Harper's Cafe before I...
Wait, you ate at the cafe here? Doesn't supporting a tourist attraction like that kind of go against your protest?
A man has to eat, doesn't he? I don't think the meager contributions of one person are going to keep this place afloat. Especially now.
And you're sleeping here? Doesn't it get cold at night?
Well, I came prepared, of course. I usually find myself with 1 or 2 extra layers to wear. Most of this bulk is padding, I promise you.
I'm sure it is. So you stayed here the whole night?
That's right. And I admit I may have heard some stranger than usual sounds floating around the swamp last night.
What kind of sounds?
It's impossible to say. This place fills with the most terrifying sounds at night. Hundreds of animals, some tiny, some much larger, awaken and make their own protests. Every night until the sun rises in the morning.
Insects make noises at night. Okay, I've written it down.
So much sass. What can you tell me about Remington?
The murder victim.
Since last night, yeah. But he was the owner of Boggy's Bog. Did you know him?
Not personally. To be honest, I'm quite glad about it.
You shouldn't say things like that to a detective. It gets us suspicious. What can you tell me about Harper?
He seems like a good person. He even sympathizes with my cause.
He agrees with your protest? But he works here, right? And he was friends with Remington.
I think that was the only reason he worked here. Maybe he'll see the light now and leave the swamp behind him. Maybe everyone will.
As they said in the intro, sound is important. The way the audio cut, I hate to say it, but the game is definitely selling this guy as highly suspicious and murdery. What can you tell me about Vanderpeer?
You're wasting your time with that one.
Yeah, I know. What can you tell me about Bobby Burl?
I have nothing to say about them.
Lady Weybridge?
You're asking the wrong person.
Folder.
Ah, yes. Agent Folder.
Oh.
A good man.
You know him?
We get on rather well. And we shared a number of views on the way things were run around here.
Boggy?
Boggy is my prime suspect, you know. The creature you're trying to protect.
Protect is the wrong word. If your suspicions were correct, we could both agree he's a creature that doesn't need protecting.
You think he might be the murderer?
I think he's a wild animal, and he wants to be left alone at any cost.
How about yourself?
A man who has sacrificed luxuries to protect those who need protecting. Pretty good beard, too.
You ever meet Sally Spears?
You're wasting your time with that one.
It was a shot in the dark.
What can you tell me about these designs for a costume? A Boggy costume.
It's Boggy! I must admit, I've been a fan of his before I ever came to the swamp.
A fan? So you're interested in cryptozoology?
Oh, no, I meant, well, Boggy has been
show.
In all kinds of cartoons and comic strips. He's one of the greatest characters of the last 100 years. I've got some comics in my tent. You really should see.
But he was only discovered 60 years ago.
Oh, that's true. Well, I bound it up.
But what about his costume? Have you seen anyone wearing it?
I can honestly say I've never seen anyone wearing anything like that. And I'm a very observant person.
What can you tell me about this flower book?
Show it to somebody else.
Explorer's journal.
This is the journal, correct? The one that man left here 60 years ago?
You seem a little unsure of the details. Shouldn't you have read up on all this stuff?
Forgive me. It's hard for me to get the image of Boggy as the lovable cartoon character out of my mind. He's just so iconic. Did you know, in 1973,
But you're protesting to protect the real swamp creature. The cartoon character is just some commercial byproduct, right?
Yes, yes, of course. No thanks, my friend. I'm afraid I have no idea.
I think he's gonna react to the
show helmet. It to somebody else.
No, okay, that didn't work.
No thanks, my friend. I'm afraid I have no idea.
Okay. I hate to admit it, I am just brute force interrogating at this point.
I'm impressed someone managed to pitch a tent here. And I'm impressed someone would want to. It's a colorful piece. It should open if I set...
I think it's 1973. It's the only date that's shown up so far.
It's a color piece.
Shit. Okay. Clues. Explorer's journal. What about the folder file? Thank you.
I'm impressed some and it's a color piece. There's a hollow part of the tree.
Hey. Yeah, I have a pretty good view of him from here. Anyone supporting animal rights is okay in my book. His protest used to have a bit more energy, though. He spends more time inside his tent these days.
And what's he doing in there?
I'm happy to say, I don't know.
There might be something I can ask Echo about. Echo spends less time holding the protest sign and more time in his tent. I wonder if Echo can tell me what he's been doing that's more important than his protest.
You know, I'm not gonna make a dirty joke right now. Let's go back to the office.
Even though I have the key, this door has two. So,
Walt. That was brutal. Well, okay, that's a lot of eyes. That's creepy.
These animals. I don't recognize any of them. Remington's desk is covered in drugs. It's all about Boggy. An ink bottle was spilled into his work. I'm sure he didn't do that on purpose. Yeesh. So perhaps there's something underneath those drawings. It's a letter Remington before some. My dear, I received your note 2 weeks ago, but have only recently found the time to do the appropriate research on the map. I feel like my time in this awful swamp might finally come to a close, all due to the simple realization. The rest is. The handwriting. Richard, our man of the world. A little help is in order. We're worried that the efforts regarding our elusive little friend might be in vain. Send word when you can. The letter is signed FF, and attached is a blurry little picture. It's some kind of metallic insect. The whole thing is a myth. Vincent Vanderpeer's business card. There's a couple of numbers scribbled on the back. Vincent Vanderpeer. There's a map of the swamp. It's been annotated. It's a letter. There's a map. It's. Something happened. There are signs of a struggle between the desk and. An old hunting rifle. This isn't the kind of thing I can. No way. No way. Is this. These animals. I don't. It's a sharp metal poker for a fireplace, hidden in the shadow. Something about those three prongs. I feel like I just stumbled.
There's the murder weapon. Yep.
The open window looks over the wooden planks. Oh, and on one side a. Something there. Something there. This is the creepiest.
Okay, here's what I think happened so far. We know for sure. Wait a minute. Where's the audio? Oh.
I probably shouldn't leave until I've. I don't know what's. I'm gonna. The open window looks... Oh, and on one side... This is the creep. These animals... Hunting memorabilia. It would be an impressive collection if it wasn't so disturbing. Photos and paintings line the wall above the fireplace, but one of the frames is empty. Wait a second. What are these pieces on the floor underneath it? This photo is ripped, but it looks important. If I can piece it together again, maybe it'll reveal a secret. This photograph, it's a young Remington, and some other men I don't know. They're all holding rifles. Maybe I can ask Harper about it. Have I uncovered a secret in here? The hunting photo explains why Richard Remington belonged to a secret society. I think there's something about Mr. Remington.
Oh, it's historical evidence.
The hunting photo is historical evidence that Richard Remington belonged to a secret society. I'm getting a strong feeling that Remington might be the bad guy in this story. Mm-hmm. If he wasn't already dead, I would have loved to ask him a couple of questions. I should ask around. See if I can gather any information about his motives for being here.
Oh, we're already on chapter 3. Okay, cool. So whoever was already in that costume...
There are bizarre... And back to...
Or at least whoever was wearing the flippers. Broke into Remington's office. There might have been a discussion about Remington. With Remington. My assumption at this point is that whoever was in that costume tried to kill him. They weren't sure how they were gonna do it, saw the fire poker, stabbed him in the chest after he fired the shotgun. Him falling out the window. Landed with a thud. Person went back down, checked the body, grabbed the piece of cloth, hid it in the helmet, left the flippers there, walked away.
Ah!
Hey there.
I heard you've been spending less time protesting recently and more time, in your tent. Normally I wouldn't pry, but it's my job to ask...
Untouched people have even noticed something like that. I usually get the impression everyone else is doing their best to ignore me.
So, you admit...
I mean,
it's true.
I would if you were to...
You can put your notebook away. There isn't really any reason for it. Nothing worth writing down, at least.
Well, if it's not worth writing down, maybe it's worth hearing.
In that case, you'd forget it.
How do you know? Maybe it would echo in my mind.
Look, if you take a guess and get it right, I promise not to deny it.
Let's work out why Echo was hidden away in his tent. Notebook time.
I have a silly nickname. Truthfully? I think it was crappy weather. I don't know. It might have been... Oh.
You've been hiding in your tent from the tax man.
Why not?
So what did Mr. Remington think of you? I mean, protesting in the middle of a swamp every day.
It wasn't his swamp. If he ever truly thought it was, then he was even more of a fool than he seemed.
But he didn't like you hanging around, right?
That man was exceptionally skilled at ignoring me, ignoring anything he didn't like.
So, what, he just left you alone?
He expected me to get bored and go home. He figured I'd get sick of this place and he'd have it back to himself.
But he didn't want it to himself, did he? He wanted lots of people to come visit all the time, surely.
I'm sure it says that in the brochure. Yes.
What?
You're not a bad detective.
Well, I found the photo in Remington's office. It was ripped up, though. I think he was some kind
of... He was a lot of things. Don't lose that picture. And show it to Mr. Harper before you leave.
Okay.
Show it to somebody else. Why are you carrying that around with you?
I have a suspicion it may have been the murder weapon.
Really? I thought Remington was attacked by something with claws, wasn't he?
He was stabbed. Let's go talk with the folder. That was at the museum.
So,
I found these designs for a boggy costume.
Oh, some ridiculous new merchandise for tourists to waste their money on.
No. I believe the murderer was dressed like this last night when they attacked Remington.
If they were trying to scare him out of the swamp, they should have spent more time making an accurate design.
What do you mean?
Well, this design is some bizarre hybrid between the real creature and the cartoon character. It simply hasn't been researched properly.
What's wrong with it?
Well, those flippers? Pure guesswork. Nothing but foolish imagination. Nobody knows what Boggy's feet look like. No footprint has ever been recorded.
So tell me, Special Agent Folder, how would you do a better job researching it if nothing has ever been recorded?
Oh, well, that's, you know, I mean, it's all a matter of taking the time to... It's just that there's no way anyone would believe nothing but foolishness.
What can you tell me about Remington?
What can you tell me about your relationship with Richard Remington?
We didn't really have one, and now we definitely don't have one. But look, all I can say is that he was a coward who enjoyed watering down history for his own benefit.
What does that mean?
It means there are some chapters of this swamp's history that he never wanted anyone to know about.
Did he like you sniffing around this museum all the time?
I don't think he knew, to be honest. And even if he did, there's nothing he could have done about it. He has no right to this building. He knows that. We both know that.
Why not? It was part of his tourist attraction, wasn't it?
No, it wasn't.
I hate when the music drops like that, because then something's wrong.
So, you found it. I wonder who else knows about it.
That's suspicious. So, let's see the challenge.
I have a bone to pick with you.
Are you setting yourself up for a joke? Something about a lockpick?
Maybe. Who knows? Stop distracting me. I'm trying to interrogate you.
My apologies. Go ahead.
So, what are we showing Folder now?
Well, there's a lot of things we could show him. Specifically...
Where did I find this again?
Oh, I found that outside the office.
I found a lockpick at the scene of the crime.
Oh, apparently you did. Why does this concern me?
You already admitted to owning one of these, and how you're ever so happy to come and go as you please with it, am I right? Be honest.
Luckily for me, Detective, I was honest with you. I believe I have already explained that second lockpick before you even found it.
You lost your lockpick in the swamp and had to buy a new one.
That's right. I appreciate you finding it for me. However, I won't ask for it back. Apparently it has since become some diabolical instrument in the art of murder.
Yeah, I wouldn't have given it back anyway. It's a piece of evidence.
This person is of no interest to me whatsoever.
I'm just covering the bases, presenting him
with
different
profiles.
If I cared
about that person, I would know everything I need to know already. Oh, yes, I know him. He occasionally asks me about the history and biology of the swamp creature. I explain to him what the real Boggy looks like and how they changed his appearance for the cartoon character.
Why did he ask about that?
Because some people are naturally curious. You should give it a try sometime.
So it's obvious Remington was trying to hunt the actual creature, him being a hunter of mythological creatures.
Next time, only show me something if it's important. Let's make that a rule.
Yeah, can I make it a rule to punch you in the face every time you give me some sass?
Well, this design is some bizarre hybrid between the real creature and the cartoon. I have no interest in something like that. Obviously.
Yeah, just covering the bases. All right.
There's a little door in the wall here.
Where else can I go? Right, I need to head to the cafe and talk to him about talk to Harper about Remington.
You said you knew Remington?
He and I knew each other for a long time. I came to work at his tourist attraction in the early days, when he needed help.
Well, what kept you here?
I know most people wouldn't want to work in a place like this. I actually like it here, so I was happy to oblige.
You might like it, but I still don't see why anyone would build a tourist attraction here.
Mr. Remington has his reasons. He probably had several. I don't presume to know what they all were. Even though we were friends, he had some secrets, some hobbies, that I was happy to let him keep secret.
Secrets? Hobbies? A secret hobby?
He was a man with a dream, I can tell you that much.
It's here a lot. I think he's been putting less effort into his protests recently, which is a shame. I think it's an admirable cause.
Do you talk to him much?
Not really. Sometimes he likes to talk, just casual conversation. He asks how business is going and what everyone likes to eat, nothing of real importance.
Which means he would know that Remington would like the bog hot dog. He would know Harper's schedule. Okay.
I don't know what to say.
One of Mr. Remington's secrets. I never wanted to know the details, but these men travel the world, seeking mysterious animals to hunt. They consider myths and legends to be the ultimate prey. It's Mr. Remington's fireplace poker. This slime on the handle. It's familiar for some reason.
I found these designs for a boggy costume. Do you know anything about them?
You're asking me because you can tell I'm experienced with needlecraft and sew my own clothes?
No, but that's a good reason. Let's go with that.
Well, these designs look like they should have stayed where they were.
In the trash?
On paper.
Oh, how come?
Whoever drew them didn't really know what they were doing.
You would have done it differently?
Of course. I am a seamstress. There was a time when I considered sewing my craft, my livelihood.
Really?
When Richard Remington arrived in the swamp years ago, I offered him some of my handmade fabric as a peace offering. I don't think he cared much for it. Most likely he threw it away. A pointless gift from some strange woman. You can put that away. I can't help you with it.
Oh, I was hoping that was the cloth she had sewn. Okay, well, let's...
Let's see. First thing, then tap.
Okay.
And now... Got it! Now I know what that liquid consists of. I'll write it down in my... That looks pretty... Let's see. First, then tap the fob. And now... Got it! Now I know what that... I'll write it down. Is that the same as last time? This was the exact same liquid. Let's see. First, then tap the faucet. And now... Got it! Now I know... What's going on here? That was definitely the same as the other tests. There's something about that green slime.
Thank you.
fireplace poker, found at the crime
scene.
Sorry, that
was too obvious that I missed
entirely.
The black
leggings are covered in the same swamp slime. Sally's leggings. They link her with the crime scene. I'll have to ask
her about it. You've been here so long, you must have crossed paths with Remington a few times. What did you think of him?
That man was a threat to the swamp.
Well, clearly.
We'd be better off without him. Hopefully the curtain will fall on his little tourist attraction as well.
Better off? With a killer on the loose now?
There have been murderers loose in the swamp before.
What are you talking about?
In my time here, I've seen the swamp invaded by men. By hunters. Several times.
Oh.
They're relentless.
What were they hunting? Wait, what about Boggy? Is that why no one has seen him in 60 years?
They always fell short of their ultimate goal. That just meant they came back again and again, doing more harm each time.
But this area is protected by law, right?
It is now, but some men have no respect for laws, of any kind. They tried to get me to leave my home. I stood my ground.
Obviously. But this whole area is a tourist attraction now. I doubt Remington would have allowed anyone to march into Boggy's Bog with a gun and start hunting down his main attraction. Let's see. First and ten.
Not gonna like what I find, am I? Oh god. It's swamp juice. The soda is swamp juice. Ew.
Got it. Now I know. Oh, why did the swamp slime? It's the exact same liquid.
I recognize some of those men. Unfortunately, they've hunted in the swamp before.
Before it became a protected area?
Before that, yes. And one of them after that. You should ask someone else.
Yeah, just covering the basics. Just in case.
Show it to someone who doesn't live in a tree. I'm not even sure who that is.
Figured I'd cover my ass.
There's samples of flowers that grow in this area. Two of them you don't see very much anymore. And one of them only grows around the museum.
Hmm. I still haven't unlocked your challenge yet. I don't like that. But I need to go to the gift shop and talk to Sally.
So what can you tell me about your relationship with Richard Remington?
I didn't have one. I think I spoke to him twice, ever. He usually seemed really busy, but more like preoccupied.
Preoccupied? Like he was thinking about something else? Something that wasn't this tourist attraction?
Who can say? What do old men think about?
What? Are you implying that I know the answer to that?
Bruh.
Is that one of the other suspects? They're more suspicious than me. Let's agree on that. I think the cartoon character is kind of dumb.
What about the real creature?
I've never met him.
Me neither. The black leggings you found in your bag this morning. They're covered in the same slime that was on the murder weapon.
Everything in this swamp is covered in slime. What's your angle, Grimoire?
Your black leggings were part of the murderer's costume.
Costume? Is that why someone took them out of my bag last night?
Well, you know, I don't have to prove someone else took them.
If I had been wearing them when I committed a crime, do you think I would hand them over to a detective the second he shows up? Besides, look at them.
They're stretched out.
They're loose and stretched.
That's right, someone else. Someone larger than me has worn these. They're stretched out, especially at the waist. It's pretty obvious.
So, let's see. Somebody stole them to use in their Boggy costume, and then put them back in your bag when they were done?
If you say so. It's not my job to know all the details. It's my job to sell souvenirs. Do you want a souvenir?
Oh, my, yes. But only if you choose one for me.
You look like you could use something to wind up. You can take this one.
Thank you.
Okay, that was a thing. Boggy's feet are again hidden in the bucket of water. Alright, well, personally, I don't suspect her at all at this point.
Not suspicious. Not suspicious.
I do not suspect her at all of being the killer. Now, Echo, on the other hand...
Not suspicious.
Actually, no, everything suspicious. About Echo is suspicious currently.
Not suspicious.
What?
Well, truthfully, let's see, where can I go? Let's head back to the protest and talk to
her. Show it to somebody else.
Jerk.
No thanks, my friend. I'm afraid I have no idea. Show it to somebody else. No thanks, my friend.
I'm just covering my butt at this point, because it doesn't feel...
Oh? You saw Remington last night, but had you met him before? Did you know him?
I've never really spoken with him, but we've come into contact a few times. Vincent likes to handle that kind of work, and I like to let him.
What do you think of this place? The tourist attraction, I mean.
I can't say I like the idea of a natural area like this becoming commercialized.
I know! I just can't understand why anyone would even try.
I think Mr. Remington had his reasons. He looked like a man with a couple of secrets.
Like what?
I have no idea. If I knew, they wouldn't be secrets. What is it? Some evidence from last night's murder?
Really, dude?
The famous director, and my friend. Try showing it to somebody different. I really don't have an opinion. My apologies. Mm-hmm. That's great.
I don't need this sass from you, buddy.
Yes, that's my photograph, taken near the woods at the north end of Boggy's Bog. Have you tried looking there?
I suppose you've met with our murder victim, Richard Remington.
Yes, I've been in and out of this place for a while now. Naturally, I've crossed paths with Remington a number of times. Good value, that one. A real raconteur, you know.
You liked him? So far, I'm getting the impression he wasn't the most popular guy around here.
Well, that much is clear, isn't it? The man obviously slipped up somewhere, made an enemy or two, and bam, that's that. You just can't be too careful, can you?
Yeah, I think he did have an enemy or two. Or three. But you liked him.
I respected him. Good head on his shoulders. Good business sense, that man. He understood how to make things work for him. I'm a busy man, and this doesn't look like it's worth my time. I simply don't have time to help you with this. You want me to sign a photograph for you? I don't really have time to be looking at items from your collection.
Really, dude? Really?
You won't be getting very far,
Not suspicious.
You know, let's talk to our guy.
Ah, try and solve every suspect's challenge topic. If you're struggling, don't forget to present profiles and clues to people who might be interested. Oh, and hurry up. It's cold in this boat.
Okay. So, let's see. Let's go back to protest. Have I showed you everyone? Yes. Have I showed you everything? No.
Show it to some...
No thanks, my... I'm afraid I...
Show it.
Shit.
All right.
This area is kind of empty. This area is kind of empty.
I'm sorry, I have not. What is it? That's the food I saw Mr. Remington eating at the cafe last night.
Aha. Before he got ill and rushed back to his office?
That's right.
This is going down in my notebook. It might be important.
Everything always is.
Mm-hmm.
Sass.
I'm sorry. What is it? Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. What is it? Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. What is it?
Showed you everyone, right?
If you... I don't really... You won't be... If you want... I don't really... You won't be...
Not even gonna lie right now, the fact that I'm having to basically just button spam to figure out whether or not the item is the right item is kind of annoying.
You won't be...
Rock, if that was a natural...
So... I've never seen...
Okay.
I have no interest in something like that.
I've showed you everyone. Lady?
You can put that away. I can't help you with it.
We've discussed everyone.
This is a 60-year-old journal.
Aha.
It was on display in a museum.
I know what it is.
I thought you might. I'm supposed to look to the past, right?
Oh.
Lady Weybridge was living in the swamp when the swamp creature was discovered by the explorer 60 years ago. Lady Weybridge. She was living here when Boggy was first discovered by the explorer.
And she's the only one I have.
I've been looking into the history of this place.
Oh, really? Did you find anything?
Yeah. You.
You must be confused. You found me today when you barged into my house. Remember?
You were already living in the swamp when the explorer came here 60 years ago.
The explorer? That man they talk about in the museum?
The one who originally discovered Boggy. You know who I'm talking about. His sketches and notes are the only real evidence we have for this creature.
You already have his journal. You learned to read, I assume. What else do you need?
There's a page missing from the journal. I think you know where it is.
Why on earth would I know something like that?
Because you were the only person here when the explorer visited the swamp. I have a suspicion that the swamp creature wasn't the only thing he discovered.
You're suggesting he gave me a page from the back of his journal? Or what, that I stole it?
I really have no idea. If I could see it, I might be able to make up my mind.
It doesn't belong in a museum. It belongs here, with me. You understand?
What if I promise I'll return it after I finish clearing up this mess?
Then I'll show it to you.
Is this you? He drew you into his journal? It's beautiful.
60 years ago, yes. He left the page with me. We agreed the rest of the world would manage without it.
I think there's something on the back. Footprints.
He has two legs at the front and one in the back.
I think I went to talk to Officer James.
Okay, so Boggy is definitely not...
Not suspicious.
Not the killer. Who does that leave? We need to talk to Officer James, of course, but... We're missing evidence. We're missing something. We need to get into Harper's...
That must be the...
We can get into Harper's area.
Ah!
What can you tell me about...
It's Boggy! I must admit, I'm...
A fan.
Oh. He's...
Cartoons and comics.
I've got some...
But he was a... But what... I heard you've... And more... Normal...
As... I...
Let's work out why Echo was hidden. Notebook time.
That's just silly.
You've been in your tent!
No, it didn't ding.
I heard... Notebook time.
I gotta say, the game is very forgiving. I think the spooky noises were keeping him inside.
You've been hiding in your tent because the swamp is...
Well, I got an achievement for it, so I'm not too terribly upset.
I am... Let's work out why...
Crappy weather.
You've been in your tent because... It's been raining!
Show it to somebody.
I could get some information if I show the picture. Oh, damn it. Oh, hey, kid!
The great detective returns. Did you run out of ideas? Need a little push in the right direction?
No need to push me, but the direction would help.
Like it or not, I'm here to help you.
I get it. You give me a map, then you magically disappear and hide behind a tree for an hour. You want me to be impressed?
Did you talk to all the suspects yet?
I'm working on it. You can't rush these things, you know.
Have you noticed anything unusual?
I notice that this is going to take longer than I originally planned, and I'm getting the feeling that I wasn't wrong about this tourist attraction.
What do you mean?
I had a hard time believing there could be a place like this here in a dark corner of a swamp. It didn't make sense, and it still doesn't.
Some things don't make sense straight away. You need to look a little closer.
At what? The mud? The water? The trees?
Nope. They've been here for years, and they're not to blame. They belong here.
She's gone again. Hiding in a bush, no doubt. I wonder if she'll ever tell me something I can actually understand.
So we're still missing one... We're missing one, two, three pieces of evidence.
So, is that the missing page of the journal?
I think so.
It's an important artifact. It belongs in a museum.
Yeah, you're not wearing the right hat to be saying that.
It's always good to get an Indiana Jones reference in. Talk to him about everyone. All right, let's sledgehammer this.
Something you found. Come back. I have no interest. This file goes over some basic differences between the genuine creature and the cartoon character. It's nothing more than a basic overview, really.
That's everything. All right. I got his stuff correct.
You won't be getting very far. If you want... I don't really have... You won't be... If you want... I don't really...
Well, that's all the clues.
Hey. Where are you keeping all this?
Oh.
Is that one of the other more suspicious? Her. One more. Is that one of your...
Let's go back to the cafe.
Can't help.
Drock? I'm at a loss.
Why don't you?
Alright. I think the only thing I'm missing at this point is getting into his tent.
I'm impressed someone might, and I.
One sec. Do I have a clue? Notes.
Not suspicious. Not suspicious. Not suspicious.
Oh?
What can you tell me? A rather prominent tree stump. Looks like this pod.
Bush out front of the museum.
It's a stepping stone path that goes past the museum, and so glad I'm wearing... I don't think it's a window, but this hatch is shut at the moment. This side of the museum is around... I don't think it's... There's less light back there.
Let's take a wander around.
What's this?
Yeah, we got the footprint. I feel like I missed something. I don't like that.
Grass. Predictably, a trash. The glamour. There's a wooden path built right. Do we expect? There's a little. I think it's. I'm not going to worry about how frail that wooden path looks. Nope. It's a humble. A boggy spot. Maybe I'll get one. Brightly colored boggy baseball. Is there? Brightly colored. Is there? Boggy dolls, boggy toys, boggy postcards. Yeah. It's a map of the swamp. Mine seems a little older than this. It's a framed drawing. What a shame. It's not even. It's a photo of the swamp entrance. There's really. Well, I wouldn't wear it. Maybe to sleep in, you know.
Yay! I got another achievement. Child Tassel, designed to look a little like Boggy. Huh. I got an idea.
No thanks, my friend.
Shit. Well, there goes my idea. Clear.
Oh? What is it? I'm sorry, I...
You only get.
It's a humble. Brightly. Is there?
We talked about everyone to her. Shit, I haven't gone over any of the loot.
Is that when he. I have no idea. This was taken near the forest at the back of the swamp, correct?
Yes, I think so.
The water is really clear back there. The legs of this thing are reflected in the bottom half of the photo. It's a nice shot, actually.
A reflection? Oh, yeah, of course. A reflection in the water.
Where are you? These hats look pretty stupid. Luckily, kids seem to like stupid stuff.
You sell a lot of them?
Yeah, they're pretty popular. I always thought it was weird that his feet are in that little bucket all the time.
It's just part of the character, I guess. I'm surprised they don't sell some sort of boggy foot soaker.
And that would be the one product I'd consider buying. Is that one of your... I have... That is... Never seen it before.
Kinda figured.
Where are you... I can draw.
Can you show me?
There's no time. Maybe in the sequel.
Hey, fourth wall break. Very nice.
Is that one of your clues?
One sec. I need to double check something to make sure my computer isn't running out of space. Nah, I still got tons of space. Okay. I had to make sure that I wasn't running out of computer space, because literally if my computer runs out of hard drive space during this recording, I will lose all of it. And the audio.
Is that one?
Because the computer will crash from a lack of space. Okay. Oh, there's notes for the area. And I'm missing something here. I'm missing something at the protest. I'm missing a lot at the museum. Shit. Something about the treehouse I missed. Oh, there are no clues at the... So I didn't get into the tent. Outside the office path. Let's go back to the museum. I'm clearly missing a lot at the museum.
It's a poster for... Swamp Stoot providing the best. Boggy playing... He's having a grand... Boggy playing... He's a... Boggy... He's a... It says... Another story from... But actually, I think this is from the very first... Apparently, this is the exact... it seems everyone is destined to lose a hat or two in this damn swamp. Some education... Did you know swamp... Things and jobs... Unless the thing is marmalade.
Ooh, marmalade.
This is a really cramped museum. Not worth it. In a diff. It's only recently been moved here to be part of the truest. That might explain why it looks so out of place.
Oh, okay. Well, that was the two. That was some of the notes I was missing. Missing one more note about the museum. I don't know.
Let's see here.
Oh, there it goes.
This journal belonged to the first discovered Boggy in the swamps.
Where else am I missing information? There were no clues at the dock. Everything at the entrance. I'm missing something at the crossroads. Hey, kiddo.
You again. Ready with some cryptic advice, no doubt?
Don't let them take him.
Who? The murderer? That's my job. I gotta make sure
that
they...
No, the creature. Don't take him away. This place is his home.
Oh, Boggy. Hey, don't worry. I didn't really believe he could be, responsible for this mess.
You didn't?
Well...
Not at all.
No. Mainly because I didn't believe he existed at all.
So, he won't get in trouble? He won't have to leave?
Well, he's been out here for, what, 60 years, hasn't he? And stayed out of trouble for that long. I have a feeling some detective isn't going to change all that in one day.
Well, in that case, he says, thank you.
Oh, because that wasn't creepy at all, sure.
Jeez.
Note to self. Those trees are more dense. Apparently, I'm not hungry.
Still missing something.
There's a hollow part. It's the base of a gigantic tree. Was this entire place built around it?
Okay, well, that was that. Alright, what about the gift shop? I got everything at the gift shop, got everything in his office, got everything at the dock, got out of the entrance, crossroad. Protest, right, okay.
Looks like this path leads to what I... Looks like this path... A rather prominent tree stump.
Ah! I'm afraid...
So, what did Mr. Remick... I mean, pro...
It...
I'm impressed someone might, and I'm... It's Echo's tent. It's Echo's... It's a cookies. It...
I honestly think it's 1973.
It's a... It's Echo's tent. So...
know what? I'm going to go talk to the officer and see what there is to see.
A lot of fog and a lot of...
Ah, you finally returned. Well, did you find the swamp creature? Where is he?
I didn't find him.
What? You're not getting paid to wander about aimlessly, Grimoire. Get back out there.
I don't need to.
Well, all right, here we go. Well, one sec. All honesty, I think Echo did it.
Suspicious. Suspicious. Not suspicious. Not suspicious.
Ah.
Not suspicious.
So we know what these guys are up to.
Not suspicious.
Oh?
Not suspicious. 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 Not suspicious.
There's one more clue missing. I could just... I think I missed something. And I'm not sure what. Now, I got 99% on all of these. I'm gonna cut the video real quick and see what sort of stuff I can look around for. Because this is getting on my damn nerves.
Those trees are...
Like, seriously, this is getting on my nerves. I should be able to find this, so I'll be right back in just a second. Hey guys, I think I had a breakthrough. Okay, so we're gonna go back to the museum. It was the poster.
It's a poster from... Copyright MCMXXXIV. That'll be 1934?
What cartoon show did Echo grow up with?
I'm impressed someone and I... It's a journal. Bad news. Remington, I don't know what to do. Was my whole protest in vain? They'll shut this place down, sure, but I'll never know if I got through to him.
Oh.
That's all he's written. There's...
Well, I feel like an asshole now. Well, let's get this case over with.
Why not? Let me...
Send the photo.
If that's not Boggy, what is it?
I found designs for the costume in a trash can. Not only that, I collected all the pieces of the costume myself. Well, nearly all of them. There's still the one that...
But the footprints at the scene of the crime! How can you prove these don't belong to a real creature?
Damn it.
What's this? I thought there were no records of a footprint anywhere.
No public records. The footprints at the crime scene don't match the ones on this page. They were just a product of these slippers. A part of the costume.
But Grimoire, this costume, it doesn't have claws of any kind. How do you explain the three wounds on the victim's chest?
Well, the fire poker, obviously.
The prongs match up with the wounds perfectly. The handle's even covered in slime, see?
Ah, but this swamp slime was one of the reasons Boggy became a suspect in the first place. Surely this only incriminates the creature further.
You'd think so, wouldn't you? But that slime, it's not exactly what you think. This stuff has an uncanny resemblance to the so-called swamp slime. A bunch of it was stolen from the storeroom of the cafe, which reminds me.
What is that, exactly?
A poisoned hot dog. It's the second reason that the murderer broke into the storeroom. He put this green powder on the entire supply, just to make sure.
To make sure of what?
That Remington would be ill and have to go back to the office.
To make sure Remington got ill and had to return to his office.
Remington went back to his office? Alone?
Mm-hmm.
I've been looking through your evidence, Grimoire. One piece in particular seems critical to me. I think we need to work
the
out...
Video footage? Vincent Vanderpeer filmed it last night, at the exact moment of the murder, I believe.
Well, exactly. I think we can both agree these sounds in the background. They're essential in our mystery. Could you talk me through them? Just rearrange the descriptions on the left to match, drag them around, and if you want to hear the...
No problem. I can always check my case for...
So, first, we heard the creaking. They grabbed the metal poker.
I think that's it.
Oh, okay, cool, perfect, got it.
Ah, excellent. There's just two small details bothering me. First of all, if Remington ripped off a piece of his curtains, why wasn't it found at the crime scene? What happened to it?
It was in the helmet.
Turns out the murderer took that piece of fabric and concealed it inside the head of the costume. Then he fled the crime scene to hide all the parts in different areas of the swamp.
Ah, well, that's my problem. If Remington fired his rifle, how did the assailant survive and manage to escape? Did Remington miss his target?
At point blank? A man of his experience? I don't think so. In fact, the answer to that question is the very last link in our chain. The one thing that has eluded me so far. I'll drag the clue items from the left onto my drawer, and we'll see what happens with the original...
Hello, I am the murderer.
Wait, you never found...
You're right. And I never would have... Not lying around. Not like the other...
But what does this have to do with the murderer surviving the rifle shot?
This torso is probably made up of some thick material. Something covering the culprit's entire upper body. I believe it may have even been enough to soften...
To soften the impact from a bullet! Aha!
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Well, let's put your theory to the test. Where is that last piece of the costume?
Truthfully? I think it's in the cafe.
Where is that?
Oh.
Where is...
Ah! Shit.
Where is that last... Where is...
Where the hell would it... Oh.
Where is...
No. Fucking...
Where is...
This is pissing me off now.
How?
Oh.
We looked everywhere. Not a single clue.
I was right. Simple. He is the killer. He was wearing
He's
it.
He's still wearing it.
I don't know what you want with me. Sounds like you two were smart enough to uncover the real criminal in this swamp. And lucky enough to have somebody else deal with him for you. You worked it out. He had his rifle on him. He got half a glance at me and pulled the trigger without hesitation.
But why would he do that? You were dressed as Buggy. He shouldn't be pointing his gun at a unique scientific specimen, not to mention his main attraction.
You're right. It doesn't make sense.
It doesn't make sense, does it? Not unless you're in on the secret.
That secret be the hunting photo leads me to believe that Remington was here to hunt Boggy.
The hunting photo leads me to believe Richard Remington was here to hunt Boggy. A secret society, an order of hunters,
seeking out mysterious and elusive creatures.
The Order goes further than this one man, and much further than this one swamp.
The whole thing is kind of distressing. I knew something was wrong as soon as I stepped into that office.
I'm glad you've finally come around. It's not just
But what about Remington? He was a member of this order?
He made Boggy his own personal project, his own obsession. For years he hunted the creature, the potential perfect addition to his collection.
But he owned the tourist attraction. He set it up himself, didn't he?
He did. It was just his way of forming a legal loophole. Since the area became protected, he and his friends were unable to come here for hunting anymore. Boggy's Bog was just a front for his own little game. A man pursuing a creature.
A creature that might not even exist.
And that's why Remington kept a rifle nearby at all times?
Well, exactly. He didn't want to take any chances.
Now, don't you see? I did this place a service. Did Boggy a service. That creature, he can live in peace again.
Can he? You tried to frame him for murder. You wanted everyone to think he was some kind of ruthless predator?
Well, think about it. Once he became suspected of murder, they'd have no choice but to shut this whole place down. Everyone would finally realize they had no business here.
How can you know what Boggy wanted?
How can you know what Boggy wanted? He might not be what you... You're...
Detective.
You. It's...
It's finished. Well, don't be angry. You should be glad. It's finally time to leave the swamp. You have another job to do.
I don't know.
Not that it makes any difference to somebody like you, but I never intended to kill him. Just to scare him. Convince him Boggy wasn't going to let him live here in peace any longer. But, true to form, he had his rifle on him. You worked out the rest yourself.
It makes a difference.
Well, Mr. Everstone, I'm afraid you'll still have to come with us. Fortunately, there's a police station just a few miles down.
Hey, wait!
Hi. Hey, buddy. He looks cool. Not even gonna lie, Boggy looks cool as hell. Hey!
Looks like you solved more than one mystery tonight.
That was a lot of fun.
Grimoire.
Well, what did they decide to do?
We had Mr. Everstone questioned. He was happy to tell us everything he knew. A number of rumors going around the department have been confirmed.
And Remington's office?
Searched, down to the last detail. And well, we agree with you. But I know what you're thinking. I'd love to put an end to it, just the same as you. But there's always...
Are we going after them?
We'd better be.
And that's how you leave it open for a sequel. You clever son of a bitch. Okay. Well, I beat Detective Grimoire in one sitting. While I'm still stuffy-nosed. I hope you guys had fun with Let's Play Detective Grimoire. Apparently I got a bunch of achievements. I didn't get Due Diligence and Slickest of Sleuths. I'm assuming that's, you know, getting the rest of the clues. Obviously. I honestly don't know where the rest of those clues are. I'm going to go off camera and... Well, no, you know what? We finished it. I'm done with this game. Well, okay, that's not what I meant to say. I'm not done with this game. I loved this game. And yeah, it played a lot like the original Flash game. It was fantastic. It was to the point. It was relatively easy. And it was fun. That was the most important thing. It was fun. There were a couple spots where I was picking up on the clues faster than Grimoire. But that's... I've grown up with detective shows. I watched, like, Elementary and Sherlock with my mom. I watch stuff like this all the time. I watch cop shows. I watch detective stories. And certain things tend to fall into place. I hate to admit it that I spotted the lead villain the moment we started talking to him. But at the same time, it was a tad obvious who he was. Because of the way he was carrying himself. Because of the way he was describing his relationship with Remington. It was a little obvious, and I'm glad I turned out to be right, because I would have looked like an asshole if I wasn't. So, anyways, I have officially burned almost 3 hours of you guys' time. I won't keep you guys hanging around any longer. I hope everyone out there had fun with Let's Play Detective Grimoire, but it appears we've run out of time for today, and I've got a bit of a headache and I need to blow my nose again. So, until we meet again, Internet... Stay classy!